have them in their time.
Yeah. But what we need to do is gather together. Thus says the Lord. Wow.
Coming along. There you go. Got it done. Boom. The man of God keeps his word. He never promises to do something he does not intend to do. And he follows through. Our Kent Hughes. Don't know what y'all's beliefs are, but this for me was an impactful morning. It's kind of later in the day. You know, I could have been outside working earlier today. It kind of took out some of my day. To me, it's important that like I've said in one of my recent posts, that the garden of my heart is healthy and that it's thriving. Just like that garden out there, I don't know if you can see it, my garden's doing good out there. I've been working on it, doing the hard work in the wintertime, so that in the springtime, whenever it's time for that life to come out, it's ready to go. It's primed and ready to go. That's what I'm doing with this, is working on the garden of my heart, if you want to say it that way. But really, the principle stands is we need to be people who keep our words and who are people of integrity. If we can keep the integrity of our hearts and keep our word, be people of our word, be people of faithfulness, man, that's just gonna be huge. I think it was significant that I made this out of just scraps around the house. You know, you can see the back. It's got all kinds of crazy nails and funny stuff. It's definitely not professionally made. To me, that paints a picture that we don't have to be perfect. We don't have to do our life with complete perfection to really make a difference. You know, this picture frame is definitely not perfect, and neither is the writing or anything like that right there. You can see right there, I forgot he, so I had to write that later. Y'all, just be encouraged. I really had a good time writing this, and I think it's gonna impact my day and my week and my month and potentially my year. Just to put this up in my room and to remember that I wanna be a man of integrity, of discipline, and of keeping my word. And really just following through on what I've said I'm gonna do. So it was a good start of the day. Now let's see what else we can get into. Y'all, thank you so much for your comments and questions. That's just awesome. I love that you guys are having all these questions and you're popping them my way. I'm excited to tackle those with you all in the coming weeks. I actually got a book here, right here. And I don't wanna get too wet, but we got like pages of y'all's questions. It looked like actually about one in every 10 to 15 people commented, and I really, really appreciate that. That's awesome. I love how much of a team we are. I'm excited to get going on tackling those questions. I laid them all out just like, wow, I'm getting wet. Basically, I laid them all out. As questions, and then I made little, you know, marks on the side if they were asked multiple times. And the one question that was asked the most was actually, what are your plans, or how do you plan for the coming spring and summer? How do you go from that to this? And then how do you know what to plant, when to plant it? Basically, how can we be like secure in knowing that we have a plan, we have a solid game plan for going forward? That is a very good question, and thankfully I've been tackling that one a little bit in the past videos, but also that's always been something on my mind, is like I don't like to
come at something without a plan. Normally my personality is actually just go with the flow, you know, go out there, just get it done and try to figure something out as you're going. But the best thing is actually to have a plan. I'm really finding that out. Coming from someone who normally would not make a plan, but is learning to make plans and how to do that, how to make designs to where you're planting the plants in the right spaces at the right times. That is something I have learned and I would love to pass that on to you all. So that will be the video tomorrow. Unless we go out and do another project, we'll have to move a little bit. But there are, I mean, 50 or so questions, more than that. There's probably 70 questions in here tackling different types of, you know, bigger questions, smaller questions. So my job right now is I am gathering all of these questions together, seeing which ones are the most pressing, and then adding those up and categorizing them so that we can have more streamlined, more straightforward answers to questions. So I'm not going to tackle any of the questions in this video, but just want to give you all that heads up. I really do want to be a man of my word. I want to be a man of integrity and loyalty. It's hard to find people like that, and it doesn't just happen. So I was blessed with some awesome parents. They gave me a great start, but now it's my turn to launch out and take what they gave me, take the seeds they gave me, and plant those again so that we can even have a bigger harvest of, like I'd like to say, awesomeness. It really takes a community to really start to make solid, tangible, real change. And I'm noticing in our world we have a serious lackage of folks who are very concerned about family, about faith, and about stewardship of the resources we have. And one of those big resources, I mean, in North America, we have some beautiful land, beautiful land. How are we gonna take care of that land? On a large scale, also on a small scale. And it all starts small, everything starts small. Just like I've been saying in my Instagram posts, like these trees came from seeds, it all starts small. So y'all, I really appreciate you coming on here and commenting with these questions and concerns. It means more to me than you know. And just the fact that y'all are following along and learning with me, I'm just excited about it. This channel is not about me, it's about you all. It's about how can I, in what I have learned already, going to Africa, going to the University of Tennessee, all my personal studies and my experience doing CSA gardens and school gardens, all of that combined, I feel it's a resource that I don't want to just hold to myself. I want to give it, I want to share it. But at the same time, I'm also learning. I'm also growing and learning how to grow, you know. We're all in different stages of growth. And my mom, she's awesome. She instilled in me a desire to really dig down and research and to find out and discover, to have that childlike curiosity. So many of us lose that when we get older, but I'm trying not to. I'm trying to hold on to it. Be curious about, wow, how does the mulch break down and what are the different components, and how do wood chips turn in this soil into just wonderful, fruitful abundance? Where can I plant plants around my house to best benefit those plants and make them fruitful, but also, you know, deal with my zone, different climates? How do we deal with pests and other problems that come up? How do we deal with the soil issues? Too much clay, too much sand. What can we grow in winter time? How do we save seed? What are different types of heirlooms that I like that have worked for me? How do you discover what heirlooms are gonna work for you? When do you plant like perennials and bushes and trees, and what are the best methods for planting those plants? Do we do it in winter time, fall, spring? What's the best timing? How to install irrigation systems? Here are just a few of those questions that we're gonna be tackling in the weeks going forward. First one I think was funny was, where's Jonah? Well, Jonah is in Georgia where he grew up and his family's over there. He's on Christmas break. He'll be coming back. Don't worry, he's coming back. How to make a chicken coop. What are my spring and summer plans for garden installs for edible landscaping? What does edible landscaping look like? What are good edible substitutes for those plants that, you know, they don't really grow any food? How can we use that same space in a beautiful but also fruitful way? How do I turn that kind of space back there into cleared land in the most efficient way? What is my plan for around the house? Oh my goodness, this thing's gonna be full by the end of the year. Maybe we should do like a question video every once in a while, maybe every quarter or every month. What do y'all think about that? I think that'd be fun. I feel like I'm just pacing back and forth. I really am, actually, because it's cold and wet. Those are some of the things we'll be tackling, folks, and this is exciting because what this is it's not me telling y'all what to do. It is me offering what I have learned so far, but also offering my desire to learn and to grow and to discover with you all what are the solutions to these problems, because we've all got problems and we all have garden problems, but there are big broader answers to problems, but also specific ones too that I'll be getting into in different climates, different growth zones that are going to be really helpful for everybody. So the rain is coming, it's hitting me harder than it was getting you all wet right now, but y'all, I'm so excited about this. I'm excited about y'all being with me, and please continue to comment with questions and stuff. I might be making a mailbox, actually, a PO box, to where y'all can send whatever you want to send, like letters or notes. I love getting letters. So letters, you could send me seeds that you like, and I'll share those things. Things like that. That'd be kind of a fun, interactive thing to do. Ooh, it's rainy. Oh my goodness. Bye, garden. See you next time. Keep on getting watered. So yeah, just fun stuff like that that we can do. I'll keep you up to date on that. I think the first thing that we'll be tackling is how to make a plan for spring coming up, because I know we all have that kind of in the back of our minds. It's Christmas time right now and everybody's busy with family, but spring's not very far. And right now is a good time to make some solid plans and start getting those seeds. My goal is to make it simple and doable for everybody so we can have a solid step-by-step plan for how to go forward and make it to where everybody, every one of you all, can create your own plan. Next time, I'm cold. See you later. Let's be people who keep our word. I'm gonna keep my word to you all and doing a video every day. I'm gonna keep my word to you all and tackling these questions. Keep growing, keep sowing. I'll see you next time.